Hello everyone, I am myself Amit Chakarwarty from Nepal. I am presenting my paper on reconstruction in Nepal after the earthquake 2015. I am the student of MBA Disaster Management, and my application is roll number is 21024. So I start with my abstract, like presenting about the Nepal after earthquake 2015, especially excuse me, hello, and my voice is repeating, so it will be just disturbing me.
Amit, you can just reduce your speaker volume. You can just reduce your speaker volume.
Yeah, okay, thank you. So I am presenting the earthquake affected needs and of people after 2015. Especially in Nepal 2015, the 14 district was fully affected with the earthquake, and more than 700,000 houses were fully damaged. And I'm working in the Dholka district where I have done the study. So there was a 70,000 household was damaged, you know, due to the earthquake. The paper, paper was on focusing on the situation after the earthquake. What was the effect and what was the recovery action taken and reconstruction action taken by the government of Nepal? So decay, like due to the Nepal is like a landlocked country, so most of the actions geography was not accessible with the road condition. So after the earthquake, many of the houses were damaged and they are not accessible with the first needs of the response. So I will start with my keywords, like damage of earthquake, emergency response and reconstruction, and coordination, how the coordination level was done during the response and recovery actions. So Nepal is a landlocked sovereign country in the located in the Sea of South Asia. It has an area of 147,181 square kilometer and population approximately 2.7 crores. And it is located in the Himalayas and border to the north of the People's Republic of the China, and to the south coast and west of the west by the Republic of the India. And therefore lies is the seasonally given regions. Historical data evidence on the occurrence of the destructive great earthquake in the past. Mitigation action of earthquake risk can be made only with the adequate assessment of the seismic hazard, which should be based on the evaluation of seismic tectonic and geographical process prevalence in the part of the world. And Kathmandu is the capital of the country and the most popular city of the country. Nepal is exposed to most of the disaster type types, including the earthquake, flood, landslide, droughts, storms, avalanches, hailstorms, fire epidemics, and ecological hazards. A wide range of psychological, geological, ecological, meteorological, and the demographic factors contribute the vulnerability of the country to the disasters. Major factor contributing to the disaster are rapid population growth, slow income development, a high degree of environment degradation and fragility to the land mass, and the high elevation on the mountain slopes. Like Nepal has already the declared by the like risk profile in Nepal was mostly risk profile was like yearly basis, the landslide and the floods are ongoing. So most of the affected household was in Tarai region was a flood, and in hilly region was a landslide. And the glacier lag of outburst is just not common, not rare, but it is not always, but sometimes it will happen in the hilly regions. And earthquake was like it was Because history 2015, like before that, before 80 years ago, in Nepal, that was an earthquake. So 8,000 household was damaged. And after in 2015, the damage was like a country declared the emergency. And the fire was really common in the Nepal. Drought and avalanches are just not much common. So in 2015 earthquake was a 7.8 Richter scale struck in the Nepal on 25th April 2015, followed by the few major and many mild aftershocks. 14 districts of central and western development region of Nepal were severely affected by the earthquake. Government of Nepal has declared the emergency and the appeal was made for the international assistance and relief packages to rescue the affected and inflicted victims. In the response, several national and international organizations extended their support to the government of Nepal by providing technical and financial assistance. As a result of earthquake, 88,790 people dead. And more than 22,300 people were injured. Assessment was shows that the at least 498,000 private houses and 2,656 government building were destroyed, and another 2,256. 1,000 private houses and 3,622 government buildings were partially damaged. In addition to 1,900 schools were destroyed and 1,100 damaged. Action was taken by the Nepal government after the earthquake was the response action strategy. That was come with the emergency appeal launched by the government of Nepal to the international and other neighbor countries, and that will help to support the in the all 14 districts with their emergency need supports in Nepal. And the response action was taken by the UN agency that is known as call and that non call as UN cluster as a cluster mechanism. So there was a nine clusters which will support the government in the every response areas. So it's less like a water and sanitation, hygiene, shelter, protection, nutrition, logistic, health, food and security, emergency telecommunication, municipality communications, education, elderly, early recovery, camp management and camp coordination. So these nine cluster was enabled in the emergency phase, and they will work together with the government and respond to all the affected families in their households. And then after the reconstruction, action strategy come with the government of Nepal. In 2015 December, the Nepal government has established the National Reconstruction Authority that will come that will support in coordination with the government of Nepal and international NGOs to support the affected households with permanent reconstruction of their houses. And there was a central district implementation unit that will be supporting the government agency in district level for the implementation of that for reconstruction action in the district, and the guiding for guideline for the mason training, guideline for the house construction was formed after the reconstruction action map strategy. Challenges we just like for the reconstruction, I'm focusing on the challenges of reconstruction. So just like the staff, in the reconstruction phase, mostly the problem was the staff, because the most of the staff was not going continuously in the field. Like government has recruited the most staff or the most engineer staff for each and every VDCs, but due to the their in supporting documents and everything, they can't reach in the field, and they resign the position. So most of the position of the those government staffs and NGO staff was vacant still now. And policies and system, like the policies and system was not familiar with the communities. As I am with the Dholka, I am presenting Dholka. So Dholka, in Dholka there was a not good coordination and sorry, like policies system for the communities. So that was all another challenges for the reconstruction, and that was a capacity. Like the after the earthquake, government has make a guideline for the construction of permanent house with the feature of earthquake resilience. But the capacity of the community people and masons haven't much capacity to construct that construction houses. And inclusive diversity was like most of the staffs and like community was not inclusive because mostly focused for the husband name, but there was a single woman. They are not enrolled in the like enrolled in the permanent housing grant. Methodology for this assessment I have carried out with the 4W matrix of the different cluster from emergency response to reconstruction phase, combining three data collection method, and desk research was carried out to the locate and analyze the documentation of the Nepal earthquake published by the different clusters and Nepal government of Nepal, community meetings conducted with the reconstruction authority and community and HRRP in Dholka and Dading Gorkha district. Best practices and lesson learned was like information and communication was good because the cluster mechanism was there. It is highly effective during the emergency response. So that will support us for the community to who are just where is the gap and where is the need. And humanitarian communication was another good practice and lesson learned from this 2015 emergency. Coordination with national and UN structure was also the good practice for this earthquake. And regional material and human resource roster information, like most of the in the early phase of earthquake, the most of the human resources was transferred from another country to support the Nepal, and devolution of the decision making to the local regional level, so that like a DDRC was a main chapter for the response mechanisms in the Nepal in district level. So that was also good for the decision was making by directly district, not for the central committee. And cash programming, especially for like a cash transfer for the community for their daily needs was also the good practices. Procurement, like in Nepal, after the earthquake, there was too much rare difficult to procure all the material, but due to the good coordination with the other